The topic there's in this presentation is the study and analysis of the polynias using polarimetric synthetic aperture radar data. In particular, we analyze the key elements of the Antarctic coastal polynias and then present and discuss the main results. The polynias are seawater regions that are free from the surrounding sea ice, as you can see from these optical images collected by the MODIS sensor invisible band. They are characterized by different shapes. They can be homogeneous or they can have some streaks of frizzy ice inside them. Unfortunately, the observation of the polynias by optical images is very complicated because these images are not available every day due to the extreme weather and illumination conditions. Polynias can be classified in open sea and coastal, as they are present in the open ocean and along the coastal area. In this research, we focused on the coastal polynias. They are generated and sustained by the katabatic winds, very cold and intense continental winds, which reinforce the process of freezing sea ice and at the same time drive it away far from the coast. The formation is sustained by a particular oceanic circulation, which is called Langmuir circulation. Its mechanism is shown in this slide. The study of the spatial temporal variations of polynias is very, very important, as it is an essential indicator for many oceanographic and climatic phenomena. In particular, they are a source of sea ice production, and they are responsible for the sea level rise as well. The polar regions are difficult to access as they are harsh environments. Therefore, traditional methods can often give a very partial view. So in this context, satellite remote sensing is a key element for polynia monitoring. So far, the observation of the polynia from the satellite is made with microwave sensors. From one side, we have the passive microwave sensor, such as radiometers, with a daily revisit time, but with a coarser spatial resolution. On the other side, we have active microwave sensor, such as the synthetic aperture radar, with a longer revisit time, but with a very fine spatial resolution of a few meters. Basically, in literature, single polarization techniques are used to obtain the polynia area. But in the most cases, polynia inside is not homogeneous, but it can have typical streaks of new ice. Our goal is to see if polarimetric information can be useful to extract the sea ice coverage inside the polynia in a simple way, only using a conventional classifier as a Wishart classifier. To process polarimetric SAR data, we can consider, for example, dual polarimetric system, and we need the covariance matrix to describe the measurements. Then it's possible to relate these measurements with the fundamental scattering mechanisms. We can do it, we can do this by using two synthetic parameters, the entropy and the mean alpha angle. The entropy represents the degree of randomness associated with the scattering of the scene, and the mean alpha angle is the average scattering angle at which the signal is received. Based on these two parameters, it's possible to develop an automatic classifier that allows us to identify the different regions observed according to the different scattering mechanisms. Let's move to the experiment. Our study area is Terranova Bay in the Western Ross Sea between the Dry Glass Key Stone and Cape Washington. In the Terranova Bay, pollinium reaches an average extent of 1,000 square kilometers. And in this zone, the most frequent pollinic events are those of short duration, of a few days. But if the cadabatic winds are particularly cold, strong, and persistent, we have a significant pollinia opening. For the purpose of this study, we use three SAR data collected by RadarSat 2 in C-band in dual polarimetric HH-HB mode. These are the multipolarization backscattering intensity images related to the HH-HB channels of the three data used for our experiments in different periods and pollinia conditions. In all image can clearly see the signature of the Terranova Bay pollinia, and we can note that these three pollinias have a different shapes and characteristics. Let's move to the first experiment. For quantitative analysis, we have selected inside the pollinia two regions of interest, a seawater regions and sea ice regions. In the HH channel, the backscattering from the seawater is characterized by large values, and the backscattering from sea ice is characterized by low values. Let's see to the HB channel. In both regions, the backscattering is much lower than in HH channel. But in this case, the backscattering from sea ice is about 3 dB larger than the seawater region. So this means that the intensity information of HH-HB channels are complementary between them. And the idea is to combine them for a better analysis. A simple way to combine these channels is to include phase information. So in this slide, we have the polarimetric entropy on the left and the mean alpha angle on the right. In particular, the entropy image shows that the seawater region is characterized by very low values, 0.2, typical of the sea. Instead, the sea ice within the pollinia results in a larger entropy, about 0.4. The same differences can be observed according to the alpha image. We see that we have about 4 degrees over the sea, while we have 12 degrees over seawater. For a deeper analysis, we consider the spatial variability of both the backscattering on the left and the polarimetric parameter on the right. We can note that the sea ice has a greater variability than the seawater. We repeated these same experiments for the other two data. And for a better visualization, this slide shows the map of the only centroids for all data, for which it deduces that the centroids of the normalized radar cross-section very much more than the corresponding polarimetric parameters, which are more stable, both on the seawater and on the sea ice. In addition, the sea ice has a greater variability than the seawater. Finally, considering the Euclidean distance between the centroids as an index of separability, we note that in the single pole case, it's not always possible to discriminate well the two zones. But in some cases, the conditions of the pollinia are such that the backscattering allows us to have a greater separability. For polarimetric analysis, then the separability always be much more, much greater than the obtained with the single pole case. This suggests a simple classifier, the Wishart classifier, to estimate the CI's cover within the polynia. As we see, the polynia is characterized by two different colors, a light blue area corresponding to the sea, an extending light green area characterized by sea ice. Based on this information, we have easily extracted the area and the percentage of the sea ice inside the polynia, which is about 30%. The same can be done also for the other two data, where you can see well that there is no presence of the ice within the polynia. In conclusion, we show how SAR allows providing fine scale information of the polynia. Dual polarimetric capability allow getting CI's coverage information within the polynia in a robust, simple, and unsupervised way. For this purpose, the revisit time is critical, but it could be at least partially overcome by exploiting multi-platform frequency pulsar observations. Thanks for the attention.